quite a maximum of the world. And I'd like to share with you all our recent conversation about the themes always to come today. In Buddhist philosophy, we have this essence that many rivers flow into one ocean, and also as many paths go to the top of the mountain. So, like other pastors, Buddhist father generation about we have one thought, even that we practice many different methods. All of us as human want to live peacefully, happy, and harmoniously. No one want to be suffering. So that is the main truth for us to approach to. Whatever things we are doing now, we try our best for our happiness and peacefulness. So, as much as we know that our principle, we care for ourselves, we care for others, based on that kind of similarities. And in Buddhist worldview, we see one last of the members. Buddha say that throughout many lifetimes, I get a lot to explain a little bit so that you understand that we believe in recognition. So throughout many lifetimes, we say that it's not easy for us to find no one has not been our father, no one has not been our mother, no one has not been our brother or sister. The point is that everyone of us is family members of each other. With that kind of understanding, we have to work together. Now, last hours in this country, we face two disasters, Katrina and Rita Hurricanes. I was in Malawi recently, right before and a couple weeks after the Katrina Hurricane. I saw many good people that they came so far away to bring the food, the supplies, the medical supplies for the people in that disaster. And of course, most of them belong to the churches, the temple, or the private sectors. Of course, many of us complain to the Russian Revolution is too slow to respond to the victim during that kind of disaster. And as you have heard many explanations of prayer recently, you see all the spirits of this religion is that we base upon the love and kindness. We base upon the care for each other. The reason why when I was there is I'm so glad that even the government agencies have not provided the support to the victim yet, but many, many people from different backgrounds came and helped the victims without any conditions. And that is the positive side of living this world. Because why? We depend upon each other politically, economically, and spiritually. Whatever happened in the Middle East would affect our nation. Whatever happened to our people in this city, Louisiana, this area, would would have to bow life. For example, we may assume too much about spending money for to opt this monastery because of the price of gas. So when Jesus says, as much as we know that we are interdependent, we need to take care of each other. The wisdom in the disaster era is like our sick member. They need our help. And we are healthy. We have to help them out. And also, according to the Buddhist principle, not only we take care for ourselves as being human beings, we need to take care of the environment, we need to take care of the animals, we need to take care of any living beings that we can encounter, that we have the chance to encounter, because somehow, like what happened with the mouse disease, or chicken disease, would be affect to our physical body, and it would affect to our economies. So the point is, we have to take care of our human beings, animal beings, and also our environment. So that is the kind of loving kindness we need to spread out everywhere. We need to develop that kind of kindness. And again, in this worldview, we don't see anyone as our enemy. The difference is only because of confusion. Because of confusion, someone creates crowds. And for all instant, if they come to the mind, if they have a problem, it's not picking up to that kind of crowds. So, we understand that one person can turn into from bad person into good person by versa with wisdom. So in Buddhism worldview, in order to live peacefully, happily, and joyfully, we need to take care of our mentality. So that we won't let the confusion to control our mind. We don't let our illusion to harm ourselves and others. So I'd like to make the conclusion by this time the sutra, that's one of the good sutras, so that we can come today. May all beings be happy at birth, whatever beings, they may be weak or strong, without exception, long, large, between the short, stable, seen and unseen, near and far, born and sick in birth. No beings be happy at birth. Let no one deceive another or destroy anyone anywhere or through angers or resistance which are not to suffer. Pass an author with reasonable life to protect her child, only child. Even so, should one cultivate a limitless birth with regards to all beings, with goodwill for the entire cosmos, cultivate a limitless birth. Above and below us all around, or Scottish, without hostility or hate, whether standing, walking, sitting, or lying down, as well as one is